Hello, this is Jennifer Martinez. This is our first video on solving equations. First, I'm going to solve the following one-step equations. Then, I'm going to solve some two-step equations. Let's look at example one. Example one says that if I take a number, x is my unknown, and I add 3, right? What unknown do I add 3 to get 8? This is called an equation. It's an equation because it has an equal sign. What number plus 3 is 8? Well, we all know the answer's 5. But to get that, when they become more complicated, what do you do? Well, what we're going to do is we're going to undo what it says here to get the original number. So it says add 3. So what we're going to do is subtract 3. Subtract 3 to both sides. What you're going to get is x is equal to 5. This makes sense because if you subtract 3 to one side and you subtract 3 to the other side, you are not changing the equation. And by subtracting 3 from both sides, you get x alone. So in example 2, it says that we take a number and we subtract 5 to get 50. So instead of subtracting 5, what I'm going to do is add 5. So even with larger numbers, you can see 55. It makes sense. 55 minus 5 is 50. So the opposite of addition is subtraction. The opposite of subtraction is addition. What is the opposite of multiplication? If you remember, when nothing is in between, it's multiplication. It's division. We're going to divide both sides by the same number to get x is equal to 4. What if I had division? I scroll down and look at example 4. What if I had x divided by 5 equals 8? What do I do there? Well, what you do, the opposite of division is multiplication. You're going to multiply both sides by the 5. We're going to choose the 5 because we want to get the x alone. So x is equal to 40. Here's a tricky one that students sometimes get wrong. Because on this question, a lot of people say, I see what she's doing. She's taking the left number and dividing. Well, no. This is 6 times what number? So you want to get x alone. So instead of dividing by 3, you got to divide both sides by 6. So the answer is not 2, is it? It is 1/2. Because 3 over 6 is 1/2. So that gives you 5 one-step equations. Let's move to two-step. Here's an example of a two-step equation. Example 6. What does this equation mean? Well, it means 2 times what number minus 5 equals 13. So we have two things going on. So what are we going to undo first? Are we going to undo the subtraction? Or are we going to undo the multiplication? Well, we're going to undo the subtraction. And that would give you 2x, notice how the minus 5s would go away, and equals 18. You always undo the subtraction, addition and subtraction first, because it is the opposite of order of operation. We're undoing the order of operation. So in order of operation, you always multiply and divide first, then add and subtract, and we want to undo all the addition and subtraction first, then undo all the multiplication and division. So our next step is to divide by 2. We get x is equal to 9, and that would be the answer. To see why this makes sense, let's scroll to the right here, and you can see that I have made a table that is evaluating versus solving. So again, evaluating. Evaluating is if you knew what x was. So if you knew what x was, what you would do is multiply by 2, and then you would subtract 5. That is the order of operation. In solving, we do the opposite, but we got to do the reverse order. So the last thing we said was subtract 5, so we're going to add 5. That's why we added 5 first. Then next, we undo the multiplication by 2, we divide by 2. It makes sense to me because in the morning, you put on your socks, then you put on your shoes. When you come home, you got to undo the last thing you did, so you got to take off your shoes first before you take off your socks. Hope that helps.